The Prime Minister Raila Amolo Odinga, government spokesman Eric Graite, the Nairobi head of IBC, Madam Ruth, ladies and gentlemen, mine will be very, very short because I think everybody's anxious. We need to go out and make sure that people are registered. But allow me to welcome you to this meeting today. And I want to thank IBC for going through this formal process, which appears to be a lot better organized, and actually is a lot better organized than the last time. Voting is an expression of opinion or preference, and for those who do not express opinion or preference are deemed to be neutral, and I'll be coming back to the dangers of being neutral. As I was sitting there, the Prime Minister showed me a writing by one gentleman called Dante in the year 1300, and the consequences of not voting by being neutral. Most of the time, most people don't give voter registration much thought, but we rely on it to work when we turn on the electoral taps. Every elected person knows that voter registration is vital, and everyone agrees that individual biometrics, electoral registration is a good thing in principle, because it means we can check IDs to make sure someone is actually legally entitled to vote. It dramatically reduces the risk of electoral fraud and should prevent any repeat, at least some of the appalling anomalies experienced in 2013 and 2007. Anybody with a pulse and who's legally entitled to vote should be tracked down and confirmed on the electoral register, and that cannot be overstated. Database errors of people who have died or who never existed because they were registered fraudulently must be crossed off the register, and this can only be achieved with a modernized online registration process that's easier and more secure than the one we've had before. Every year in Nairobi, statistics indicate that of the 4 million people, 80,000 people die. There must be an automatic electronic mechanism of removing these people from not only the registration database, but also the voter registers. In this day of technological advancement, voter registration should be part of a wider program of digital transformation, one which is easy to find, always available, quick and simple to use. If you don't have to go to the bank to get your money, which you keep with your life, why should voter registration and voting be any different? We need to move from an old-fashioned paper-based box-ticking process, obsessed system that was conceived for an analog world, to a modern, flexible, digital answer that matches what we all expect, and backed by another complementary digital system, which is what the Kiraitu and Orengo led committee proposed and was adopted. I want to urge the Electoral Commission to use data they already hold on residents to engage with local institutions and stakeholders to enlist help from these institutions, including civil society, so that we're able to reach as many voters as possible and underrepresented groups. The Electoral Commission also needs to work closely with political parties, and we are quite happy that we have representation, political parties, and we are very happy because the Prime Minister was the head of CORD, so it fits because of the importance of this session to come. This voter registration exercise is about giving people chance to stand on the polling station, not as taxpayers or pensioners or as students or public sector workers or aspirational voters, but as citizens waiting to cast their vote, waiting to make their mark. That's what we are in it for, and I'm looking forward to working with everybody in this room so that we can give opportunities to as many Nairobians as possible to be part of this process. I believe that everyone should vote because everyone has an opinion to make a choice. In Kenya's democracy, we value our ability to choose who's in office and revel in the fact that we have a say in what goes on in how we are managed. However, when less than half the country is voting, or half the people vote, the potential number of voters we know in this coming year is about 26 million. So, unless we have more than 14 million people to vote, then whatever results that will come out will not validate or express or represent the opinion of Kenyans. Yes, many people will argue, of course it is. We still have elections, but look at this way. The whole process, purpose of democracy is for every person to have a say in what goes on, and when less than half the country is voting, not everyone's voice is heard. And when not everyone is being heard, then that's not democracy. Ladies and gentlemen, what concerns us most is the fact that most of the people who don't vote are young. Those are between the ages of 18 and 24 years old. Even though many people are opinionated and have the different beliefs and ideas as seen on social media, most millennials have removed themselves from the electoral process. And I think the deputy governor did address himself to a great extent on that. Today I want to urge all of you to present here to think of ways of not only engaging this group to register as voters, but also to come out and vote on the 8th of August, 2017. When I first heard of this statistic of people not registered, I was shocked. We always assume that everyone votes, but that's not the reality. What I found hardest to believe was the fact that only about half of the millennials actually actively voice their thoughts and choices. Because of this and the fact that voters quite literally have the future of the country in their hands, I urge any and all people to realize how big a part of democracy voting is and use this opportunity to give them and make a difference to this country. During the last mass voter registration exercise, we heard of massive voter importation and the attendant insecurity which it caused. I want to discourage candidates and to desist from involving themselves in voter importation. And let voters be allowed to vote only from areas where they understand well, most preferably from where they live or work. How do you vote for a governor, a senator, an MP in an area you know nothing about? And as I conclude, citizens of many countries complain about the world around them, and many don't have the option to change their circumstances. However, we do. The people of Kenya have the power to make decisions that can affect our country. If you don't like the way our country is run, and yet you don't vote in elections or make your opinions heard, then you, not the government, is at fault. Remember, as the poet Plato said, bad leaders are voted in by good citizens who do not vote. I hope that my few remarks have helped you put into perspective why we need to encourage people to vote. You personally can make Kenya a stronger country by making the electoral process better, and that means registering as a voter. If you don't like the way Kenya is run, and yet you don't vote in elections or make your opinions, then you are the one who's at fault and not the government. I want to finish by saying that yes, we do have issues. Not every person who's eligible to vote have their IDs. And not everybody who's applied for IDs have gotten their IDs back, because we're told there are millions of IDs that have been given but have either been sent to the wrong destinations or have not been collected by the persons who are registered. Two groups of people we know: that young people in Nairobi, when they are going to get IDs, they are being told to go back to the father's chief in the village. We are Nairobians. We don't come from villages. We live in Nairobi. We work in Nairobi. So Nairobi people should be given IDs in Nairobi to enable them to vote. Also, the women, when they are married, when they go for IDs, they are told to go back to the parents where they were born so that they can get the IDs. That discrimination is unconstitutional. The third thing is the number of kits, and I think that has been said to a large extent. We were looking at the numbers. We have about 270 in Nairobi, and at 100 each in 30 days, Madam Ruth, you can only register 810,000, yet you want us to register 904,000. And given the number and the speed at which they are operationalized, because at 100 per day, that's just optimum, probably that needs to be looked at. The second thing is the issue, and I've mentioned it, on voter importation. We know that last year, the beginning of last year, we lost lives in Kariobangi, and we lost lives in Dandora because of protests on voter importation. And there is no need to cause insecurity by bringing people who are not Nairobians to be part of Nairobi. And I'm glad that the deputy county police commander said that they provide security. The first line of security is Nikinga. Let's not bring people who bring in security. These are transported voters. The third thing is, as people will be looking for votes, let's concentrate on peaceful registrations. On our utterances, we know that there are people who find it difficult to keep their mouths shut or keep their mouths from spewing vitriol and abuses. This is not the time to do that. Last but not least, let's go out. If you do not have a voter's card, please do get it. And I mentioned that the Prime Minister pointed out to me on what was written by Dante in the year 1300, and Dante said, the deepest part and the hottest part of hell is reserved for those who keep or maintain neutrality during the times of great issues of moral decisions. Not voting is immoral. If you don't vote, if you don't take your card, you'll go to the deepest part and hottest part of hell. So without further ado, allow me to invite the Prime Minister, Raila Amolo Odinga, party leader of ODM, to come and address you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.